My goal with this project was to gather some different perspectives of a woman's experience in graduate school. I wanted to understand what choices were involved in making the decision to go to graduate school, and what those choices might lead to. In order to do this, I interviewed three women with different experiences. I asked them to tell me what led them to graduate school, and to analyze their choices in terms of some of the research that I had gathered in the course of my project. I first interviewed Sharon Mead, my mother. I chose to interview her specifically because she did not choose a career in academia, even after completing a master's degree. Instead, she went to work for Hewlett-Packard, and later became a stay-at-home mother so that she could raise my sister and me. Now she spends much of her time creating artwork.
I went to, I had my undergraduate degree at the University of Texas and graduated in 1974, and then I went to Purdue University in Indiana for a Master's of Science in Computer Science. So it was in 1974, and I was there for 2 years in the degree program. Then I got married, and I was still there for 2 more years working in the School of Science while my husband was finishing his PhD. I got a graduate assistantship while I was there, so I taught beginning computer science for business majors. I found that a very scary experience, and I did that for the first year, I think, and then after that I worked in a research program. It was a fairly small department because computer science was relatively new. There were kind of two populations of master's students, those who had assistantships and therefore were in offices on the floor with computers with the department, and then those who were didn't. And generally, because we're all in offices on the same floor, we had a community of students, the graduate students, both for the master's and for the PhD program. And I did that because I felt, for one thing, the School of Science at the University of Texas did not have a computer science degree when I graduated from there. Actually, I graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Math. They had one, actually. The first year they had it was the year that I graduated. But it wasn't announced till about a year before that. And in order to get that degree, I would have had to take 2 years of lab science, which didn't seem very relevant to what I wanted, and so I took the computer science classes. And I didn't feel like I was really quite ready, really quite new enough to work to get a good job that I would want to have. And I got a lot of advice from different people to go to a different school for graduate school than for undergraduates, so that's why I applied to a variety of different schools and then chose Purdue. They have the oldest computer science department in the nation.
After she told me about her experiences in graduate school, I began to wonder more about my mother's choices not to go into academia. Some of the research I had read indicated that many women did not even consider academia because they perceived inherent conflicts with the process of childbearing. So, I asked her if this had been on her mind while she was making her career choices.
Well, my first time through graduate school, I wasn't really thinking a lot about childbearing. I think I was mostly interested in industry because the salaries were higher. It wasn't necessarily because it was more hospitable or less hospitable to women at all. In fact, I think the schedules are more rigid in industry than they are. But I was really just focusing on establishing a career. I began thinking more about childbearing time as I started getting on towards about 30. And actually, I had my kids and went back to work after each one. And then after about when my son was in kindergarten, I decided to, what was supposed to be at the time, a leave of absence, to spend some time at home with them. Not so much because I felt that I wasn't able to provide for them adequately, emotionally, and all the rest of it, but when I was at work, but because I wanted to be there.
My next interview was with Stacy Furia, a graduate student in the Department of Sociology at UCSB. I first met Stacy when we were both taking a military science exercise class. Later, I got to know her better when I took a course that she taught in the summer of 2006. Because she is still in graduate school, she brings a perspective to this project that neither of my other interviewees could.
All right, so I did my undergraduate degree at Vanderbilt University, and during my sophomore year, I already knew exactly what I wanted to do. I was working towards a double major in sociology and women's studies, and I was talking to my advisor about doing an honors thesis the next year, because we did a two-year honors thesis. It was both your junior and senior year, and I was really into the academic side of things. I really liked school. I really liked taking classes. I really liked the idea of continuing that pursuit, and I was good at it, and it was one of the first things I realized I was really good at, which is kind of funny, because most people go to school to get out of it, and I loved it. I loved being in school. I did extra work over the summers. I always did extra work in my classes, and so it just sort of made sense that grad school would be the next step. And it was really sophomore year that I realized that grad school was an option, because my whole life growing up, I knew that I was supposed to go to college. That was sort of an expectation in my family, but I didn't really know what to do beyond that. So when I found out that I could be a doctor without having to deal with blood and stuff, I thought that was pretty cool. I liked the idea of having the title, but I also liked the idea of being able to produce knowledge. Plus, I was very idealistic, as I still am, and I really think that the way to change the world, which is one of the things I want to do, is through education and helping people understand the way the world works. So I thought, well, what better way than to be a professor? Then you can train a lot of people who are going to go on to do really important things and help them to think about the world in different ways, which is the sociology side of things. And then the women's studies side of things would be to change gender relations and help out the inequality, some of the inequalities that exist. So I was thinking, hey, this would be a great idea.
Stacy's altruistic goal of educating young people on issues that she valued was inspiring to me because in my own academic pursuits, I have found that many teachers are more interested in publishing their writing than passing on their knowledge to students. Given her clear devotion to teaching, I wondered what plans Stacy had for mixing her family life with her academic career. She was able to give a unique perspective because in the course of her studies, she had read the same article that I was using as my primary piece of research.
Okay,